Many museum visitors don't realize, but this is the outer wall of the medical examiner's repository for 9/11 remains.
We're in what was the basement of the North Tower.
Yes.
And this is completely out of the path of the museum. It's hidden around the corner.
Yes.
Next to the repository, this is the entrance to the office of the Chief Medical Examiner Family Reflection Room. The room and repository have never been seen by the public. Families only can call a number on the door which summons an escort, often Dr. Jennifer Odian.
So the visits are different every time. Some families are very emotional, and I'll sit in with them for an hour and just hear stories. And I'll walk around with them until I know that they're okay. And then I leave the room completely so they have the space to themselves.
This must be a burden to you.
I don't consider it a burden. It's tough. I definitely have moments of, you know, feeling very emotional and needing to step back. But when I talk to a family and they say thank you, how grateful they are that with our continued work, that a question I've answered helped them in some way, it makes it all worth it.
Gordon Haberman invited us inside as his guest. No camera, but we were allowed to record the audio. We found a small sitting room and a window into the repository for human remains.
The window we're looking through looks like it's about 5 feet wide and 3 feet or so tall, just a single window, and a single wooden bench in front of the window.
With permission, we gave our notes to an artist who sketched the view through the window that joins the family room to the repository. A loved one, sitting on the bench, sees a deep, austere, white room with rows of dark wooden cabinets 8 feet tall. They hold about 10,000 remains, both known and unknown. It is, in a sense, a private national shrine.
After you. Why do you come here after all these years?
I feel close to my daughter. She wasn't meant to be here, but she's here.